It's a bit like Cheers, where everyone knows your name.
I can't explain how much I love it. It's just amazing.
I literally play every night, in Saturday and Sunday mornings.
It's some place that you can just show up, not knowing anyone, and walk away with new friends, and maybe some new skills, and a lot of sweat.
I love the game. You just get hooked. I don't know.
Pickleball is one of those sports where you have to be able to laugh at yourself, because sometimes that ball does some strange things.
I would say pickleball is a combination of tennis and a child with ping pong. So you're playing on a smaller tennis court, but then you encompass some rules of ping pong, serving diagonally. But then there are a couple of things that make pickleball pickleball. One is the kitchen, the other is the two bounce rule.
Well, welcome to the pickleball court. We have the back baseline here, and then up here it changes color. We've got a light blue. This area is called the NVZ. It's called the non-volley zone. It's also called the kitchen. So the party is at the kitchen. This is where you want to be because this is where the good action is.
Until recently, no one up here in the North Country ever heard of pickleball. So if you wanted to have a conversation starter, you'd say, well, I play pickleball, and immediately people say, well, what's that? My name is Jim Clacius. I'm one of the people that got pickleball started in Bloomington here many years ago, 2005.
We affectionately call him the father of Minnesota pickleball because he brought it back from Arizona and introduced it here to the folks in Bloomington and surrounding areas.
Rachel usually beat my pants. That was okay. The first courts in Bloomington were at Edgewood back in 2005. When we came back, we thought we needed to have some place to play in Bloomington here because it was so much fun. But there weren't any courts available. And so I went to the park and rec people and talked to them about it. And then they said they would line it so we could play both tennis and pickleball on one of the two courts. And I said, well, do them both. No, no, you don't have enough people. There's no one else going to play this game. So I said, well, okay, give me the one court and we'll see.
I had gone down to Florida to play tennis with my dad, and he couldn't play tennis anymore. He was 79 years old. And he said, I can't play anymore. And my heart just sank because he was my athletic hero. He said, it's okay, I found a new sport. And I said, at 79, what new sport do you pick up? And he said, pickleball. And I came back to Bloomington and I Googled, where can I play pickleball in the state of Minnesota? And there was one place, and it happened to be a mile from my house.
When we were first playing, we had people coming in from Northfield, from Woodbury, from Waconia, all over the whole area here to play because we had the only courts.
We would take chalk, and chalk the lines. And then I brought bungee cord and windshield wiper fluid. And we needed to lower the tennis net from 36 down to 34. And we were a ragtag bunch. My dad and I got to play on those courts. And I have his original paddle here, held together by some electrical tape and some duct tape.
And we offered free lessons to get people to come and play. And we played that site for what, maybe 2 years, I think. And we had so many people there waiting in lawn chairs. We convinced Karen Nordstrom on the console to come by one day. And she saw all the people waiting there to play. And we got her support. And she convinced the city that they should do something and give us a few more courts. And so that's how we got to Westwood. Some of our players then began to go back to neighboring communities and get them to start putting in pickleball courts as well. Gradually, we just kind of spread out all over the metropolitan area.
Westwood pickleball courts aren't the only pickleball courts in Bloomington either. They are the only ones with eight at a time, but as we're resurfacing our tennis courts, we're dual striping them for pickleball, so there may be a court closer to you than you think.
Another one of the draws, there are multi-generations that play together.
When my grandsons were young, maybe 5 and 7, I introduced them to pickleball, telling them they can hit the ball and they can't hit it hard. For the first time, I allowed them to come to the Westwood courts. Now they're 9 and 11. Let me tell you, it was super fun.
There's very few sports that you can be very competitive on the court, multi-generational, so you can have mixed doubles, you can have men's and women's, and you can have grandmas and grandpas and moms and dads and grandchildren, and again, it can be a very competitive match.
When I have these young kids, 20-year-olds, say, Sue, come and play with us. Let me tell you, that makes you feel really good. It's like, oh wow, I mean, they want to. It makes me want to keep my game in shape.
It's not a sport that you go home holding a grudge or feeling bad about losing or gloating about winning. It's more about just being out here with people and playing and getting some exercise.
Not only get people together, but you make new friends.
After my wife died 2 years ago, said you gotta do something, and pickleball saved my life. It's got me to lose weight, and it builds community.
And all the people here are super friendly. Even, you know, I just started to meet all these new people, and they're super inviting.
You see your neighbors who's around you.
One of the reasons we pushed for getting a court like Westwood here is that we wanted people to, if they wanted to play, they could just show up and there would be other people there.
That's another thing I love about this game. Is it's not like you show up and you play with your four people.
Don't be scared. Go out there and just play with them and be friendly. Everybody's friendly there, so you know.
I love how inclusive this community is. You can be a 5-0 level player, you can be a beginner, and everybody is very welcoming. There's a great rotation system, so if you've never played or traveled here to the Bloomington courts, I would highly encourage you to, because you do just really wonderful with all the people just yearning to play with you.
So I got double certified to be an instructor so that I could spread the pickleball love, just like Jim originally did for me.
I didn't know that they were going to name the courts after me. I knew nothing about it. If I had known it was going to go on, there would be another name on there. It would be Clatious Barber, because John Barber is the one who helped get the new version of Westwood the way it is.
So on Father's Day this year, I wanted to really honor him and I wanted to honor my dad. And so I offered free clinics on that day. And Jim graciously showed up and talked a little bit about the early days. And all of the participants, they just really cherish that time with him. It'll be an annual offering to honor Jim and all those whose shoulders we stand on and we have to thank for bringing pickleball to Minnesota.
I hope it will continue to grow. I come out here today and I look at the people playing, and most of the people I don't recognize because I haven't been able to play for the last 2 years. And so we've had all these new people. The courts today were full.
We all just want to play pickleball for the rest of our life because it gives us life. And it gives us life because we're outside, we're being athletic, we're having fun, we're meeting new people, we're laughing on the court. All the endorphins that get built up from this sport, that's part of what makes it addicting, because you want to get another hit.
Yeah.
Not another hit here, but also another hit of this adrenaline. Nice playing, partner.
Hey, you guys.
Good game.